How many times have you been this lucky? You gotta love it when there's plaster walls and you're doing a mini split.
Time, timer flash, 7 times.
ETU system.
You ain't testing, you're guessing. What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much for tuning in. Guys, these ductless mini split systems are awesome. Awesome. They're high efficient, they heat and cool, and they really are sleek and very, very modern looking. But there's one thing that I hate about them. Those damn control boards inside of here, they cost a fortune to replace and install. And half the times you gotta wait days, if not a week, for the part to come in. But during this install of a Daikin dual zone mini split system, we're installing the ICM493 single phase LIDE monitor with built-in surge protection. Ladies and gentlemen, they say good things come in small packages, but you know what? That can't be further from the truth. This surge protector phase line monitor is ideal for protecting mini splits. And guess what? It's made in the USA, right in North Syracuse, New York.
All right, so there is the indoor unit. Peter did a great job, even cleaned up on top of the cabinet. Very nice, very, very nice. See, and there's no dirt down there too. Quality doesn't cost, it pays, ladies and gentlemen. Peter, pat yourself on the back. Did a great job.
Thank you.
Excellent. So there's the 9,000 BTU unit. Let's go to the next bedroom.
And like magic, here we are.
Okay, this location right there is getting our next unit right there. Now, I typically don't like to position them near beds where it's going to be blowing on them, but that's where the homeowner wants it to be, right there. So let's get that bad boy in. All right, so for this room, customer wants it on this wall. We're going to center it between that wall and the window. Between the wall and the window is 64 inches. Half of 64 is 32. I put a mark right there. That's my 32 inch. And I have a height from the ceiling to the bottom of my unit in the other bedroom of 14 inches. We're going to match that here. All right, I got my wall mounted. I got my wall mount bracket mounted to the wall. What I don't get though is, see what it says there? If fixing unit, fix here would screw both side. What the hell does that mean?
I get it. I know what it means, but what the hell?
Seriously, if fixing unit, fix here would screw there and there. So I fixed the unit with the screw. Yeah, a little pop that right there, but it's behind the unit. So we're good. Now, I like to do my line side connections outside. From this mark to there is 6 5/8 inches. And we want to be as close to the bottom as possible to allow our drainage of condensate. All right, so I used a pilot bit. I drilled a hole, 6 5/8, and I left enough room for my hole saw to make a nice round hole right there. All right, so let's go outside and look to see where that penetration is. All right, perfect. There's the other penetration. So what we're gonna do here is we're gonna put the other unit right here. We'll come down with a nice little piece of ductless, the mini split cover right there. Here, we're going to tie in to there with a T and utilize the existing 100 and then come across and go back to that one. We have plenty of room in the 100 to fit multiple line sets. I only got one in there right now. As you can see, we'll fit multiple in there. Hi, Peter.
Hello.
Hi. How's your hole?
It's pretty great.
Excellent. Okay. We drilled our hole. I like to run my communication wire first. We're going to insert into the back of the Daikin, okay, through there, and then we'll tie it around to there, and then we'll fix this, fit it on the wall. Peter, pull the wire. Okay. All right, there she is. You know what? She doesn't look level, but the torpedo don't lie. And I guess the only one way, only real way of testing is do a water test, but all right, let's wire it up. We have four wires, black, white, red, green. So we have our voltage coming in, 1, 2, and 3, and our ground.
Tie that into our communication wire.
All right, so we're back outside. Here's the game plan. We're gonna put a wall outlet there, come straight down, add a, add a T there maybe. I don't really know how we're gonna do this. No, we're going to come down there, wall outlet, a flat 90, come down, go inside this line set, and then come up with a T right there and connect to our unit there. All right, I use the Rector Seal wall mount bracket. There she is. So much better than that piece of crap DiversiTech one. This is personally my first Daikin that I'm installing. The other ones that we've installed, Daniel and Peter have done. But a couple observations. Take a look at the profile of this unit and versus that. Just look at this, guys. This is a 18,000 BTU Fujitsu. This is the AOU 18RLX. RLXFZ? Yeah, RLXFZ. That's also an 18,000 BTU unit. Crazy, right? Absolutely crazy, the difference in sizes with these two. This one, you know, every time we mount them to the wall mount bracket, we always go forward as close as forward as possible, and I'm easily able to catch those. Here, if I was all the way up here with it, there was nothing to connect it to in the back. Look how tiny this is, guys. Incredible. Incredible. I'm just blown away. I really am. Take a look at the model number here. And there she is. The 2MX18. 18,000 BTU dual zone unit. It's crazy. Unfortunately, even though Daikin has that huge, and I would love to see it, the huge manufacturing facility in Texas, this is still manufactured in Malaysia. Now, for those of you who don't know, Daikin is the world's largest, when it comes to volume, HVAC manufacturer, right? And they're taking the lead with utilizing R32 refrigerant for their systems. Now, it's not all of them right now. It's just single zones, the Atmosphera. This still uses R410A, quote unquote, you know, ozone friendly, but it's actually not. Go figure. But it's a really nice machine. I was able to easily install this on the wall mount bracket, which is, you know, a 4 feet elevation off grade. Easily was able to do it myself. And I used a few lag bolts, 1, 2, and 3. 18 and a quarter inch spread from my feet. So I set that. Only complaint is that in order to fix, right, or fit that screw, I take off the fan shroud. Other than that, she's beautiful. All right, I'm gonna start running some line set covers here and there and get the show on the road. All right, I have a piece of 100 millimeter cover starting at my wall inlet, going down behind the unit. Perfect, I had an extra piece. I have my flexible drain tubing also in place. I just secured that with some electric tape. Guys, this works for me. I've been doing it this way for 17 years. This works, guys. A lot of people like to use the hard 3/4 PVC piping. I like to use the flex corrugated when I'm doing runs like this. On runs like that, right? That you should be using straight hard pipe, okay? Because just not, just asking for trouble, all right? I am going to prepare
my line set, my 3/8 and my 1/4 inch. We're going to be using the torque wrench. We're going to be using the NAVAC flaring tool. And we'll be deferring to the manual for torque specifications, right? So we have 1/4 inch pipe. We're going to use 18 Newton meters of pressure. I believe NM is Newton meters. And on the 3/8, we're going to use 42. For foot per pound, 13.3 and 31. So 18, 42. Remember that, guys. All right, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to show you now the proper way to make these connections. We're going to use a flare, 3/8 flare right there. And we're going to use a torque wrench to tighten up this nut. All right, guys, you have to forgive me. I did the 3/8. Oh, did I just break a nail? Yeah, I did. Look at that. Damn it. Damn. I did the 3/8. The landscaper was next door blowing. So you guys didn't see that, but we're going to do the 1/4 inch now. Some of you like to deburr. I don't like to. I don't see the need. We're using the NAVAC auto flaring tool. I don't see the need for it. All right, guys, so we're all finished here. We had to wait for the electrician to come in. He had to bring in a 20-amp, 220, 240-amp circuit with a disconnect that powers the ICM493. Let me take you inside under the hood of this bad boy. So I really got to tell you, this is how you really build relationships with your customers, especially when you're putting in very sensitive equipment like mini split systems. Regardless of the manufacturer, it's a win-win. You know, you take one surge that kills that board. Well, let me tell you something. That thing pays for. You change one of these boards, you can put in 10 of those. I'm telling you. But it's pretty cool. You have a little LED display there. It gives us the incoming line voltage, which is 238 volts. Let me take off the little screw right there and show you the guts of it. All right, so I removed that one Phillips screw and it's hinged, so it slides down. You can tighten up those screws by the left and right side. We have a contactor right there that's going to break the current should there be a fault on our left side. This is our load side. So we have T1, T2, followed by T3 and T4. That's how it's labeled on the wiring schematic right there. So on the left-hand side, that's your incoming voltage. On the right side, that's going to your connected equipment. So there you can see I have my ground lug. I have L1 and L2, and I even put some nice little zip ties there to make it nice and neat and clean. Here's our control board. We have a 24-volt transformer. We have a 3-amp fuse. Got a few relays, but other than that, it is very, very, very simple, and it really does a great job here. You know, protecting compressors, the motors, and other sensitive electrically controlled devices like a ductless mini split system. You know, gonna protect against phase loss, under and over voltage, line protection, line voltage issues from the power grid. You know, that power you're getting from that power line, not always clean, even if you're paying 20 cents a kilowatt hour here in the New York metropolitan Long Island area. Awesome. So one of these is really, really, really priceless. Awesome equipment. Awesome. UL recognized. It's really, really great. If you're interested in getting the ICM 494, you can pick it up at you know, your local HVAC plumbing or electrical supply house, jacksonsystems.com, possibly supplyhouse.com, Amazon, or you can reach out to ICM. They're in North Syracuse, New York. What's awesome about this is that they have great customer service and it's made in the United States of America. Another great feature of the ICM 493 is the over and under line voltage monitoring. That is where this unit really, really shines. If you got a ductless unit, you want this ICM. All right, so that basically wraps it up. This is a NEMA Type 3R enclosure for weather resistance and damaging surge containment. We have fault history, surge protection feedback on an easy to read backlit display right there. Okay. And like I said, most of all, it's manufactured in upstate New York in a vertically integrated ISO 9001 2015 facility, and this is the only complete solution in the marketplace. Only one. And what's most important about this, it's developed with feedback from HVAC distributors, manufacturers, and technicians. Check them out. Go to ICM, Google it, and check out the ICM 493. All right, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for watching. A little personal feedback. You know what? It's a really, really nice device, the ICM 493. You know what? It's not that expensive. You know, all in with tax, delivered to your door, it's under $300. What does one of those control boards inside a ductless mini split cost? Do the math. Do the math, and it's well worth it. One feedback, one constructive criticism. It'd be really, really nice if they can integrate a disconnect to actually turn off the power in that box. My local jurisdiction, you know, even though we're following the electrical code, we still need a physical means of disconnect to that device, and we don't have it. So we have to add that disconnect box. So ICM, if you're listening, it'd be really nice for the New York metropolitan Long Island area. You know, we need built-in shutoff inside the unit. If I'm wrong, reach out to me, Mike at MikeyPipes.com. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I really appreciate it. And a huge shout out to ICM for sponsoring this video. Thanks a lot, guys. Be well. God bless. Stay safe.